Welcome, nonlinear regression functions using STAT and R. This is our topic for today. We are going to reproduce empirical results in chapter 8, Introduction to Econometrics by Stock and Watson. We have these three fundamental questions and we are going to answer these questions with the help of empirical results. As I mentioned earlier, that we must always try to think hard rather than just going for a mechanical recipe, because data analysis is rarely that simple. Use expert judgment, use your brain more than just having models. Models always have some limitations. Even in architecture, where laws of physics are followed, Kemper Arena, you can browse it and you will see that this model collapsed, their architecture collapsed after winning the award within 24 hours. Okay, try to develop precise questions so that you can have precise answers. And we are going to now use STATA to reproduce these results in exactly same format as it is shown in this slide, and then we'll use R and we'll use the same thing using R. And in STATA, I'm going to again discuss this command as doc so that you can export your STATA tables to MS Word with just this simple command. Instead of consuming a lot of time on generating variables and all that, to keep this video short and to get maximum out of it, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a do file. This is given. You can slightly modify. It's given in Introduction to Econometrics, Stork and Watson, Student Resources. So we know we have this data. You can see the description of this data. We have been discussing it for last many chapters, chapter 4 to chapter 8. And as I mentioned in previous video on nonlinear regression functions, that we need to generate average income square, we need to generate average income cube, we need to generate log of income, log test, log income square, log income cube, and their interactions as well. So you can generate these variables by just select these variables. This is your do file and run it. Now you have these variables generated here and you can use them. So equation 2 given in chapter 8, you can just regress. I am going to tell you another very useful command, ESTSTO and ESTSTAB, and then similarly you can generate some other tables. At the moment we are going to generate 7 columns as I demonstrated in the slide, and we are going to generate those 7 columns. The first column is, usually we regress this one. Usually we say regress, but today I am going to do it like this way, EST, STO, and this will store your table table in EST1. Similarly, this will be my column 1, and similarly I'll run column 2, column 3, and before each column you need to write EST, STO, and you have column 3, column 4, column 5, 6, 7, and okay, please be with me after this. Look here, I regress this. Okay, no error, fine. No, there are 7 regressions, and we have discussed these 7 regressions in previous video. Now, how can we display these tables here in a nice format? Because most of our students have to spare lot of time in editing these tables. So I'm going to use ESTTAB. If you just run this, now you have all these 7 columns here. And we have discussed these 7 columns in our previous video, that this shows that non-linearities have an impact, but in general, whether you introduce include these interactions or just student-teacher ratio square or not, that will not make much difference. But for that, you can read that. Okay, one thing is this. Similarly, if you want to display additional statistics, use here SE R square. 2. So you see, you have no number of observations displayed, and you have R square and standard errors displayed in parentheses. I am going to finish this video with another very important command, and that is sdoc, sdoc, doc, estdoc. That's it. Now you have a file, my file, and you just click on it. You have these nice tables in Word format. This additional statistics is causing little bit issue. So you can have these tables in Word format. Okay, I can just if I est okay as doc estdab save my file. Let's see what happens. Okay, you can use this command. Okay, if I have done it again, and now if you open this command, so again a slight error. I'm not getting exactly what's wrong here, but I just do it for another thing as doc, and if you summarize test score, student teacher ratio, percentage English learners, or meal underscore PCT. And now if you open this, okay. We were actually looking at the last, at the upper table. Now all these files are basically given here. So you can see that this nice table is generated. So all these tables, without having a manual effort, you have here in column form. Thank you for watching. Take care. Read this chapter if you want to get maximum out of it, and do empirical exercises at the end of this chapter.